Hi Sagittarius, this is your next 7 days reading starting from 14th of September to the 21st of September. I am going to look at this time period for you to understand what energies are coming in. Your cards are in front of me. I have clarified it. I have seen and read the cards, tried to understand what's coming for you. There are some oracle cards as well to understand this general life situation. This is also a general reading in the sense that it is for the collective of Sagittarius people having sun sign, moon sign, definitely ascendant sign, or it is also called rising sign and Venus sign. So if you have position of Sagittarius in important placement in your natal chart, you can watch this reading. So the sun card is in your environment. So this is telling us that right now in this time period, you are having the source is blessing you. Source is the sun. It's blessing you with good energies. So there could be clarity, there could be good health, there could be coming back into good health, there could be name fame, there could be support in the environment, there could be someone trying to keep you happy, or they are putting up a happy face. So basically it's a collective environment of people who are close to you. Good friends, good happiness situation is happening. Children could be giving you happiness, or work is giving you happiness, or lover is giving you happiness. Whoever it is, you are succeeding and that is giving you great happiness. So in this, so if we just see a bit of the negative or the critical issue when sun is in the environment, is that maybe someone is trying to put up a very bubbly front, but they look at their gestures or look at their expressions carefully, or their hand or eye movement or their feet. So whether they are shuffling their feet, whether what is happening, but this is a very small observation, not for everybody, but there could be a Gemini around you, or there could be Aquarius, Libra, Gemini around you. That person could be or some direct talking or rude, there is some rude environment or strict environment around you. So that creates some issues. There could be a deceptive person who comes and goes in your life, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or you could be finding the correct strategy in this time period and taking step which is fast. So the magician is around you. So this is fast talking. Someone could be chattering, talking to you. Someone is giving some great expressions, or you are expressing very well in this time period. You have gotten the idea of a strategy in this time period. Maybe you are using it, or against someone's deception, or against someone's smartness, or someone who is hiding something, you are able to see clearly what they are intending. So basically judgment and the fortune is around you. So the wheel of fortune is turning very fast, but whatever is happening in this time period, if there is some kind of divine intervention, or if there is there are things happening around you on which you have no control, but suddenly you are seeing divine intervention and judgment is going in your favor. So this is that kind of energy. You could be in Two of Pentacles, you could be doing two things at a time, or you are multitasking at this time. You are able to manage. That is what it is showing. There could be a victory in this week. There could be in this week you could be feeling very victorious or getting lot of attention from people. So things are going in your favor, whether it is a result, whether it is a test number, whether it is some kind of interview, whether it is succeeding with people, or finding a girlfriend or boyfriend, of getting attention on social media, whatever it is, judgment is in your favor, and this is happening because you have this, you know, very courageous Sagittarius energy which comes twice in your reading, Nine of Wands. So you have gone through various circumstances that exhausted you. It could be in your profession, it could be in your love life, it could be in general life, it could be in health. So you have gone through a step-by-step difficult situation, but at every step with your staff which you are holding in your hand, you have been able to fight off challenges, and you are bold in this time period. You have crossed so many difficulties and you are still standing. So you don't give up. You have this indomitable energy which is showing in your reading, and with the temperance and the strength, it is, you know, endorsing this. These two big energies are with you. You are very, very courageous, very bold. You are showing your power and strength in some matter. And with the temperance card, you are also negotiating a peaceful situation for yourself, and you are healing. So basically, in health situation, you will show great health coming back to you in this time period. You could be showing a champion kind of energy in this time period. You could be able to, you know, find a position or a place for yourself which is good, comfortable, and this is happening because of your strength card and other temperance card. So it is also showing that you keep mum, you don't shout at people. You are in this time period, you are showing your great patience, and with the world card, you, because of this energy, you are entering an upgrade in your life. So this week is going to see some endings or a rebirth of some sort, getting into a new upgraded situation in your life, and that is happening after a great setback which you have gone through, with the heartbreak, with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy, or with a stability situation in your life. Slow movements were happening. With the Ten of Swords, some kind of karmic ending has taken place, and the weighing of options between two situations. One could be two jobs, where one job was you were thinking of leaving. It could be two people, one is deceptive, other person they could be cheating you or stealing something from you or avoiding you. So whatever it is, you were in two situation. So two of swords and two of pentacles, you were trying to manage a situation, you were blocked in a certain situation, but that setback is ending. And with the Chariot card, because of your gumption, because of your conviction, like I said, you have this champion energy, so you are going to triumph in the end. So the problems that you were facing, or the critical situation of health, or problems in your work or study or your business, is going to go away with the Ace of Swords. So you will realize your power, you will realize your strength. With the Moon and the Magician, you could be very creative, you could be getting premonition, you could be influenced by the Moon in this time period, and Moon brings in creativity, Moon brings in secret energies, and the Magician, once it comes, that intuitive download comes, you start magically performing miracles. So this is, you know, an energy of a creative person. So you are going to create something, or you are dealing with a Gemini, Virgo, or Cancer, or a Pisces, and Ace of Swords is telling me victory in chaos will come to you. Someone is going to speak up in this time period. Some endings will take place with Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy or a Scorpio energy. Death card and King of Swords is telling me you could be having air in your chart yourself, and you could be dealing with some kind of transformation in this time period. You are transforming as a person to deal with, you know, problems in life, stalemates in life, and finally, you know, speaking directly to someone or keeping your your throat chakra will be activated with the King of Swords energy, speaking your truth and directly expressing it and not shying away or hiding in this time period. So it could be either or, either someone else's truth is out and that will be revealed, and that will be for your advantage, or you are going to speak up, you are going to be strict, you are going to keep your boundary, you are going to not give up in between, you are not giving up, but now you are going to move ahead. There will be a breakthrough, judgment will take place, and you are going to clarify some situations. There is going to be clear thinking and a release of old belief systems. So whether it is applicable to your work, whether it is applicable to your love life, or whether it is your health situation, speaking the truth to yourself as well, you know, bringing in regimen, bringing in some structure in your work, and you know, fixing your goals and moving forward. That is what the change will be. You will be quick-witted in this time period. You will be sharp, and you are going to get this air energy. So air energy is close to you, or a pentacle energy is close to you. So practical, intelligent, intellectual energy, creative energy is coming to you. So something is transforming, something is ending. With the Ace of Wands and Ace of Cups, you are starting afresh, full power. You will be inspired, you will be innovative, and with the Ace of Cups, you will start loving yourself, feeling better, and cure, treatment, renewal of love. Old love situations could be over now. You will start courtship, or you will feel better. So there was some obstacle or problems with a Queen of Swords energy. So maybe Gemini, Aquarius, Libra, or a very strict person was around you. There was this difficult energy. You are going to move on from this. You are going to move on. You are going to get out of a difficult circumstance, someone's influence, and that is going to give you a lot of freedom. So Six of Pentacles is telling me that it is your advantage. So this could be that people were using you or taking advantage of you, but you will directly tell them that this much is what is possible, beyond that is not possible. So you will be still generous. You will be receiving something which someone took away from you, or you will be receiving some gifts, or you could be blessed in this time period, and your monetary situation or your general practical life will come back to normal, and people will start reciprocating towards you. So your tough stance, your strength, your courage will bring back balance in your life. So Six of Wands and Six of Pentacles is what you are getting in this week. So there was a bad health situation, there was a privileged lady or a lady who could be strict or a bit deceptive, or you know, someone is younger than you and they could be ill, or they could be going through some problem, or you could be the one who was going through some bad health or some problem. There will be concern around you, but very soon you are going to end something, some kind of incarceration for some of you. It's going to end. Past is past. Something somewhere in the past, you felt you felt that you are kind of kept in some kind of lock and key, or you were kept in some kind of sheltered environment, but that situation is ending. Someone was bossing, someone was trying to keep you in a boundary, but that is ending in your life at this time, and you are free to, free for courtship. You are free for making connections with people. So let's read out the angels and ancestors card. So the autumn card is coming for you. It is telling us to release the old and rest. So release all of the pressure and expectation weighing you down. Maybe someone was expecting too much from you. Shed it all so that you can recover before moving into a time of renewal. So definitely renewal is coming. Innovative energies are coming in to take you towards a new high. So autumn is when the trees are preparing for the long cold winter and must let go of the weight they are carrying in order to continue to grow and prosper. So you know what is heavy, what is holding you back. Is it a person, a situation, or a dream? Like the trees let go of their leaves and fruits in autumn, it's time to let it go. When you hold on, you try to control reality, and that never works. When you let go, you make space for the new to enter your life. So you are being guided by your angels and nature herself to release whatever is stopping you from moving forward. We are all ready to welcome autumn in this time period, and you can also do this when the autumn card arrives in the future position of a spread. So this is your last card which has come in your reading. It can also indicate that the coming autumn will usher in important energies for you with regards to whatever is on your mind. So this is what I have for you. Definitely a sense of freedom, directness, finding your voice could be what you want, and you are going to express, you are going to speak, you are going to achieve that champion position definitely in this coming month or coming week. Many of you will be seeing many changes. So this is if you have liked this reading, Sagittarius, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you want to contact me for a personal reading, you can write to me through the email ID in the description box. The readings are prepaid, pre-booked, and pre-slotted. So if you are new to the channel, please do subscribe, and you can follow some readings before coming to me. So enjoy and keep your chin up. And always be good to others, whether they are good or bad to you. You keep yourself balanced. And Six of Pentacles in advantage always tells us that even if people do bad towards us, but because this is your advantage, you are a do-gooder, you will always be the same. You will always do good for others. So this is what I have for you. Enjoy this week. Bye-bye.